Everybody, so glad to have you here for this video. This is a tutorial I love so much, and I love it because the eyeshadow look is really low maintenance, easy to put together, but yet the impact you get from it is so strong and bold. And so this is a look that can take the place of your typical gray or black smoky eye because it is a navy blue smoky eye. And really the entire eye is going to be surrounded by gorgeous navy blue shades that are going to make the whites of your eye pop. So if you're thinking, you know, I like smoky eyes, but it just makes me look a little too dark in the eye area, here's something that's going to allow the color and the whites of your eye to really glow in this look. So I'm really excited to show it to you, and stay tuned till the end because I'll share what's on my eyes and lips to help pull the look together. So keep on watching. You can first prime your lid. I used my Palladio Herbal Eyeshadow Primer all over my lid, and then I'm taking a jumbo shadow pencil in a really rich navy blue color. And the one that I love these shadow sticks from Mally. They're the Evercolor shadow sticks, and this shade is called Nautical, and it is a gorgeous navy blue. And so what we're going to do with this is basically draw this all over our lid, and you can see how that blue color, it plays a big part in how this look actually comes off. And I'm really getting it on heavier towards the lash line, and then you can see I'm just practically dotting it up to my crease there. And I wouldn't probably go to my crease with a lot of shadow pencils, but this is one that I know will really last. So I'm going up to there and then kind of dotting it around, and then also getting a little bit of that on my lower lash line here. So just, I mean, you can dot this in because this does give you, before it really sets in there, a period of time where you can blend this out. So I'm gonna get my cap back on here, and then I'm just gonna take my finger and basically just dab over this, and this is going to just kind of pull the whole product together. Anywhere where you dotted it for a lighter concentration of color is going to really start to come together, and the warmth of your finger is just going to melt that right in. When you're blending the lower lash line, a Q-tip can be a great way to once again just kind of pull the product together. And we're going for, this is not precise, this is kind of smoky, smudgy, and the Q-tip can be a great way to help finish that look. And I'm gonna take a gorgeous blue shadow from NYX called Frosted Ocean. And this is the most beautiful blue shadow. It's like a true royal blue with a gorgeous kind of metallic shimmer to it. So I love this. I'm gonna be taking my e.l.f. flat eyeshadow brush. Any flat brush will do. I like the flat one from Sigma as well. I'm kind of looking down, and then I'm gonna be patting this shade. Oops, didn't get enough on there. Patting the shade all over that shadow stick. And this really mimics the same shade in the shadow stick, but I just think it gives it just even more of a vibrant look on the lid. Flipping my brush over and pulling some of that product up to the crease. We're not doing a really precise outer V with this look. This is just kind of, you know, follow the natural crease and just kind of go up ever so slightly so some of this blue becomes visible there. It creates this nice little shadow, as you can see, right over your lid. This is just a bare fluffy brush. This is a Sigma SS224, and I am just blending that right over there just to give it a little more of a softened look, and this is probably blending the shadow stick and the shadow just a little bit there. And then, because we want to incorporate some of this lovely shadow on our lower lash line, I'm taking this brush that I love from Sonia Kashuk, Little Smudger Brush. Such a great brush to have in your brush wardrobe. And I've picked up a little bit of that shadow. We're kind of bringing these two together, the upper lash line and the lower lash line. And then I'm just, in no real precise way, once again, this is a smudgy, smoky look, just carrying that all over the lower lash line. And if you really want to smudge it out, you will turn the brush from flat like that to more up and down, more of a north-south direction there and just blend right over this. The only other shadow shade we're using here is one that I love from NYX, and it is called Aloha. Just a great highlight shade, and I'm going back with the SS224, and a fluffier dome brush will do. Pick up a little bit of that color there. And I'm just gonna take that right up under the brow and just let that blend slightly on top of where you have the blue there. So I'm gonna take Aloha in this tiny detail brush that I got from Coastal Scents that I love. It's the smallest brush I own. And I'm just going right around that corner, just the slightest pop of color. And feel free to bring it up just a bit, kind of overlap those blues. And it's gonna create a nice little blend. I'm gonna put a black liner on my waterline, and I have discovered one that will last me pretty much all day without me having to reapply it, and it's the Mally Evercolor Automatic Waterproof Eyeliner, and I like that it doesn't have to be sharpened either. This shade is Onyx. What I'm doing is just getting that all over my waterline, all the way to the extreme inner corner there. And then for some added depth on the upper lash line, just using that same liner and just kind of going, I'm not winging this out or anything, just going right along the lash line. You want to just go over that with your Q-tip. You only have a little time to do that because this will set and not move. Next, I'm going to curl my lashes and apply a couple coats of the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara. As you can see, I have the mini size here. I'm just trying it out. Apply a couple of coats to the top and the bottom lashes. Next, I'm going to apply my Ardell Fashion Lashes number 106. I really like these because you get kind of a mix of longer and shorter lashes here. It gives you a nice amount of thickness without an overwhelming amount of length. And what I've just done is taken my Revlon Precision Lash Glue, the glue that I love and swear by, and I just put that all over the upper lash line, and this is going to dry to where you can't even see it. But now that I've got that on there and I've waited probably about 30 seconds, and then I'm just going to kind of look down into my mirror and align these with the center of my eyelid and then just kind of press them on. So here we go. I'm looking down, applying them right there, really paying attention to where the center is going. And then I like to just use my fingers and kind of pat along that lash line and make sure that they are on the lash line as close to my lashes as they can get while still being on my lash line. And then I kind of blink onto my finger and make sure that they are, you know, kind of tilting up in the way I want them to. And then you may want to apply one more coat of the mascara. This is going to help to just kind of blend the two, both your natural lashes and the false lashes. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial that, like I said, is by far not the most difficult tutorial I've ever done. It's something I could easily have just told somebody, you know, take a shadow stick, take the shadow and whatever, but I love how it brightens the face while still being kind of dramatic and smoky at the same time. So in terms of what's going on cheeks and lips here, I went with sort of an overall peachy kind of vibe here. It's really pretty light. I was actually reading Makeup by Mario's blog. I'll link to it below, but he does a lot of makeup on Kim Kardashian, and he had a particular look that he was describing all the products he used, and one of the products he used as sort of her face contour was actually a really affordable drugstore product, and it's from CoverGirl, and it's the Cheekers Bronzer in Golden Tan. This has a little bit of shimmer to it, but not a whole lot, and I went lightly, sort of used it on the as a contour for my forehead and also just under the cheekbone too. My cheeks, I used my standard blush that I love, the Milani Minerals blush in Mai Tai, perfect peachy shade. And then on my lips, I used one of the NYX Jumbo Lip Pencils in Pink Nude. And this is really kind of a sheer lip pencil. It's very pink and pearly, so I just drew that all over my lips. And then for that last pop of peach, I used the NYX Mega Shine Lip Gloss in Perfect. And this looks kind of pinky here, but it really is that classic pinky peach with a little bit of shimmer to it. So it is still kind of sheer, but I like it because it really lets the eyes be the star of the show for this look. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you like this tutorial and have a wonderful day.